One report shows that the defendant was moving away from his teenage fantasy of jihad. He went back to school. He walked away. And tragically, the FBI kept pulling him back. You've heard about his writings in praise of 9/11, and there's plenty to be angry about. But we are hearing things that just do not make sense. He did absolutely nothing to prepare, build, or even contemplate a weapon of mass destruction. The FBI's own assessment was that he didn't know how, and that he would take no action without specific instructions. Beginning in November of 2009, the FBI began their year-long, tried-and-true campaign of inducement. They started with emails about bringing the war to the West, about bringing a U.S. city to its knees. These early attempts failed. The defendant moved away from jihadi thinking. He went back to school. He walked away. The FBI continued with their email campaign for 7 months, and still, the defendant did not take the bait. When their email schemes didn't work, the FBI brought in undercover agents, Yusuf and Hussein, two older, more sophisticated men who were scientifically selected to take advantage of the defendant's psychological profile, including his marijuana use and religious conflicts. They claimed to be assessing. However, we saw several examples of how they manipulated a defendant and how they created evidence. The missing FBI tape from the first undercover meeting on July 30th creates reasonable doubt. You heard the FBI electronics expert first testify that he left the recorder on the day before and then changed his story to the recorder spontaneously turned itself on while in its plastic box. This is simply not plausible. What was on that missing tape? Well, on the next meeting, on August 19th, the defendant was saying, "Remember last time? Yusuf shuts him up and prevents him from speaking aloud what common sense dictates. The Pioneer Square plan came from Yusuf, not the defendant. When he was a juvenile, still in high school, he did communicate with Samir Khan. What he was doing was writing, talking, spending too much time online, creating an online avatar that was not real. This discursive community is simply not a threat. He was all talk and no action." The arrest scene on November 26th shows the degree of scripting and control the FBI had. Why did they fake arrest Hussein? Why was he yelling? Why did he whisper that he was going to make a run for it? Why all of the stagecraft? The defendant was quiet and compliant at the arrest scene, probably wondering if it was real. Only after Agent Trustis says something in Arabic does he kick out. Agent Chin says, "Good, good." He looks defiant. This shows the subtle power and level of scripting in the FBI's plans. How did the FBI get a conflicted, manipulable kid to push the button? The answer is in the psychological experiments of Stanley Milgram on obeying authority figures. Dr. Milgram found that 60% of normal, healthy people would deliver life-threatening shocks to test subjects based on instructions from an authority figure. This whole FBI plan is a social experiment from hell. Milgram on steroids. You saw how the FBI spent months on normalizing the idea of an attack in the U.S., how they brought in very effective people in Yusuf and Hussein to create an overseas fantasy world to which they held the keys. They gave the defendant very specific instructions. They isolated him psychologically. They controlled his every move. The FBI knew the defendant was looking for guidance, and they provided him with the mentors from hell. The government cannot create the crime they solve. And this time, they simply went too far. I ask that you hold the government to the proper standard and return not guilty.
Southern trees bear strange fruit, blood on the leaves and blood at the root. Black bodies swinging in the southern breeze. Strange fruit hanging. hanging from the poplar trees. Pastoral scene of the gallant south.
This edition of Democracy Here! Was brought to you by KBOO members. Thank you, members.